All right, it's a special edition of Leahey's Locker Room. I'm here at Punahou School with the head football coach, Kale Ane, who we are honoring here on Cover 2 as the 2014 Coach of the Year. Congratulations, Coach. How do you feel about winning the award?
I'm very humbled. I think anytime you get something like this, it represents the whole organization. You know, it's more than just one person. It's your staff, it's the kids, it's the administration. So very grateful to accept this on behalf of all the people who had a big part in this.
Yep. An unbeaten Buff and Blue team here to this point. Can you talk specifically about this year's group of guys? It seems as though when they play, they are very businesslike. This is a team that goes out there. You don't see necessarily that much emotion, at least in usual circumstances. They're just out to get the job done.
They're a reflection of the coach, of me, and our staff. I think we are low-key individuals. We're very competitive, but you know, we like to be poised as much as possible and no drama, yeah, no excitement. Enjoy the opportunity, work hard, have passion for what you do. But, you know, understand that it's another opportunity, and that's how we behave.
One more game to get the job fully completed, though, and that's, of course, against Mililani Friday in the state championship game. What's it going to be like?
Well, it's going to be loud. It's going to be exciting. They got great athletes all over the field, both offense, defense, special teams. They're steady. So it's going to take all three phases of the game to stay with them. And we've got a lot of respect for them. And I know they're talented, and we're excited about the opportunity, and we're excited to be back in the big show again.
Cynics will point out that we gave this award the day before the state championship game to Rod York last year, so I'm hoping that there is no Cover 2 jinx. If for some reason something goes wrong, feel free to blame us.
You know, I actually thought about that, but I didn't want to bring it up, of course. You know, I'm glad you did, but yeah, I know the jinx is over.
Yeah, the jinx is over. Yeah, there you go.
Hey, congratulations, Coach. Again, well-deserved, and good luck against Mililani in the state championship
game.
Back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks a lot, Kanoa. Congratulations, Coach. All right, fellas, it is that time of the night, giving out plate lunches and slushies, courtesy of our good friends at Rainbow Drive-In. Mr. Brian Teo, who's getting your two scoops tonight?
My two scoops is going to my wife.
Aww.
And, for coming, you know, she drives me here, yeah. She picks me up from work, and, hon, you complete me.
That is the sweetest thing really that is. I've ever heard uttered before a slushie and plate lunch.
Yes, we will share night. This one tonight.
Date night over here. Sammy Spangler, who's getting your two scoops? You giving out to your girlfriend?
No. They're going out. Carnivine Noah is not my girlfriend. But here at Club, two scoops. You know, we didn't get to give him the Cover 2 Offensive Player of the Year award, but if there's a career lifetime achievement award, got to go out to this dude. He's only, as we mentioned earlier in the show, 22 yards shy of breaking the all-time Hawaii receiving yards record. Just an amazing career for this guy. And he's done it in 10 less games than Gerald Welch had. So pretty incredible career for Kanoa Leahey. He definitely deserves some recognition.
Absolute stud, yeah. That guy is. And along those lines, congrats to Coach of the Year, Kale Ane. But my two scoops going out to Nanakuli head coach, Keala Watson, leading the Golden Hawks to his first OIE title since 1983. He is doing big things in the Valley and on and off the field. Big ups to the big man. Now, we usually don't do this here on Cover 2, but it's a special night. There's some special games. I'm going to ask for some predictions. Coach Brian Teo, who you got tomorrow night?
Well, you know, I don't really know anything about the game, and no one really listens to me anyway, except for maybe my 8-year-old. But I'm going to say that this is going to go to the Buff and Blue and to the Lunas.
All right. Sammy, who you got?
I'm sticking there with you, Brian. I just cheated off his little test sheet over here. I got the Buff and Blue. I think it's going to be one of the most amazing games we're going to see in Hawaii high school football as far as Division I, and the Lunas just have it rolling right now. They're so hot in Division II. Buff and Blue and Lunas, but don't be surprised by anything tomorrow night.
I'm not as artistic as you guys, but I got the Trojans and the Lunas. I love the experience of Lahaina Luna. Seven guys, like Jordan Helly told us earlier, that have been there and done that. Played four straight years on varsity for the Lunas. They've been in these kinds of situations. Mililani, I love that O-line and weapons galore, that wide receiver unit. Vavai Malapiai, Mackenzie Milton. This is going to be fun, though. I think you are right that it is going to live up to the hype. It's not going to be one of those games that's a dud. This
It's going to be a close
one. Both games will be barn burner. Amazing.
I hope so. We've been waiting forever for this matchup in Division One, and then Division Two. Obviously, these teams rematch in 2012, so we've been waiting for this one.
All right, the wait's almost over. That does it for us here on Season 2 of Cover 2 for Sam Spangler, Brian Teo, Kanoa Leahey, our director, amazing, talented dude Paul Higa, our entire Cover 2 crew. I'm Rob DeMello. Thanks for watching, everybody. Enjoy title night, and mahalo for the support of Cover 2. See you next year. Aloha.